Hello everybody out in Steamitland, Aaron Daly here with another video tutorial. Today I'm going to be taking you through the VLC Media Player as well as the Mixcraft 7 music production software and the AvidMux video editor software for the purpose of adding and remixing audio on any video that you have taken. If you've ever wondered how people add background music and retain the original audio track or get rid of the original audio track completely, this will show you how to do that as well as some basic mastering techniques using Mixcraft 7. The AvidMux software can be obtained for free as well as the VLC Media Player software. They are both open source and there are links on my post directing you to where you can download them for free. Mixcraft 7 costs money. However, you can download a free demo that will run for 2 weeks, fully functioning. Otherwise, it costs around $300 for the entire software package. There is a stripped down version for cheaper, however. I've been using Mixcraft 7 for probably 10 years or so. Not as much as I could or should have, and so I know far less about it than I should. But what I know is very useful, and I hope you find it useful as well. So let's get started without any further ado. Today I am working on a video I made a while back of my dog chasing solar reflected light. Let's see if we can locate that real quick. Let's see. Okay, so this is the original video I shot. Alright, so as you can see, there's just the audio that was recorded by the camera. I shot this using a Nikon Coolpix camera. I can show you. Coolpix Nikon, it's a 12 megapixel camera. I've found this to be a really decent camera to use. In fact, when I buy a camera to take on the go, I always buy the same kind every time. These things are fantastic. I got this one used at a pawn shop in Berkeley, California, for about $80. When the light's good, the picture's even better than you see right now, and it picks up good audio as well. So, what we do, and as you can see, I'm using VLC Media Player 2.26 Umbrella. Now, I actually just recently discovered that you can even do this with VLC. I had just been using it as a media player. It plays movies and music as well. But it turns out, you can go down here to convert and save. And if you add the same file that you already have open, you can go directly to it without opening the file first, but I have found for some reason that doesn't work. It glitches out and freezes. So what you want to do is open the file first in the media player so that it's running, and then at that point you go to media, click down on convert save. You will then re-add the same file that you're viewing now, then click on convert save again. Now you choose what media form you want to convert it into. So you can do all kinds of things, as you see here. These are all the options that will let you convert into different video formats, including the audio. And if you scroll down, you can do other formats that just do the audio. And for today's purposes, that is what we will be doing. We're going to select audio MP3. Once that's done, you want to give the file a name. So I'm going to call this Solar Reflection Audio Only Raw 1. And it will automatically save that file to the same directory where the original file was located. You can, of course, change the destination to any directory. Click on Browse, select your directory, and it'll save it there. And it will also blank out the file name. Okay. Oop. What happens when Aaron types too fast? Okay, and start. Now, it runs through this real quick. It will then take you back to the original file and start playing it. You just close that. And now we can look in the directory where we were. We can scroll down here, and there's our new file we just created. Double click on it. And now we have the audio only. All right. That takes us to step number two. And for this, use. All right, so to make it simple, just go with the defaults because it really doesn't matter. You can change everything once you're in there. So it gives you two audio tracks to begin with. Have one audio track selected. You're going to go here. And we're going to add a sound. This is how you add pre-created tracks that are not in a Mixcraft format. You can put MP3s, waves. There's a number of different file formats that are supported. We're not working with Sweet Child of Mine. All right, so here we see the file we created. I made a couple of them earlier because I started doing this and I thought, hey, I'll make a video on how to do it. All right, so that gives us our first track, the original track from the video. Go ahead and play that. Oh. And you can adjust the volume on that track very simply by sliding this bar. This works as mixing it. So whatever level you set this to, when you mix down to the final file, that's the level that's the sound level it'll be at. So what it sounds like based on this is what it'll sound like after you finish creating the recording. All right, so we need to now add whatever background music. In this case, I'm going to add a sort of electronic remix I have been working on for Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses. There's nothing from their recording in this. It's all been programmed by me. So I don't think I'm infringing on any. There we go. Sweet Child of Mine. Okay, we're going to use this one. Alright. Now, it's going to by default stick it up at the top. If you hold control and use your mouse wheel, it will actually scroll sideways through this. If you put your mouse over the track and use your scroll wheel, it will zoom in and out, effectively stretching out the timeline, giving you more or less detail on the sound wave. Alright, so it appended it to the end of the first track, but we want it to run at the same time. So we're just gonna slide it down there. Okay, you can adjust these windows so you can see more. There we go. As I was saying, see, you can zoom in and out. Alright, you hit your home key, takes you right back to the beginning, hit spacebar. Really loud, so I'm going to crank that down a little bit. Alright. So we want to be able to hear the music as well as the background from the original video at the same time, but we would like the music to be slightly more prominent. So let's give this a shot and see how it sounds. Don't need the whole track, so we're gonna get rid of part of it. And this is where zooming in and zooming out really becomes useful, because you can zoom in and get right to the exact point so that it just snaps to it. Since the audio on that ends there, let's see. All right, So what we want to do is now this out. I don't want to even get into that second verse. So we're going to click on it right here. And we're going to click split. Now, you'll notice that this track here was the only one highlighted with the white around it. So it was the only one that got split. You can actually select both tracks. If you like, hit this one, hold control, and hit not that. There, and hit that. Hit the bar up here. It's important that you hit the bar up here. Otherwise, it will change, do a volume change. In order to select the tracks, you have to hit the dark green bar at the top of it. All right, so you hold control down and it'll select both of those. If I were to split it now, it would split both of them. Like, I can actually do that. Split. There, see, it splits both the tracks. So now they are independent sections. But you hit control Z and it undoes it immediately. Okay, so we split this track where we wanted it gone. Then what we do, click on the bar, select that track, and hit delete, and it's gone. All right. Now, we can zoom back out, so this is all right, one part. There we go. A little bigger. Yeah, that's perfect. Okay. We're gonna try this out and see how it sounds. That's pretty much all it takes, like really basic, without doing a whole lot of mixing, mastering, or anything like that. With Mixcraft 7, doing a quick mastering on anything is super easy. If you hit the FX button here, it will do the effects for the entire project, or you can click on the individual tracks effects button. So in this case, the only thing I'd want to try messing with really would be the audio from the video, since the track I created has already been mixed and mastered the way I want it for the time being. So you click on effects and go up here to select effects chain, and you'll see a few options right here where they have presets for mastering. And you'll notice if you do this, especially with your own vocal recording, that it makes a really dramatic difference, So like, for instance, let's go ahead. Anyway, we don't need to mess with that at all for this. So we're just going to unselect that, unmute that. So yeah, this is good for now. The final step to this, if you felt that you've reached the levels, the mixing levels you want, is to go to File and Mix Down, and you have a number of formats you can go to. I choose MP3, it's the most commonly accepted and easiest to use. It says I've made changes to the project. I haven't saved this project yet, and I don't really need to because I'm going to keep working with it open like this, so I'm going to say no, but you could save the project at this time. And if you select no, it takes you right to saving the file. Give the file a name. First, I'm going to select the directory I want to save it to. I don't really have a folder for this yet, do I? Give your file a name. And save. Alright. There you go. It immediately will play the file once it's finished. Alright, the sound's alright for now for our purposes. Okay, final step is to add the track to your video. So, we do that by opening AvidMux. As I mentioned earlier, AvidMux is free for download. AvidMux 2.6.6, multi-platform video editor. You can go to www.avidmux.org and download it. AvidMux is free software. You can redistribute and or modify it under the terms of the new general public license version 2. So there you go. All right. You can open the file, or you can just drag and drop it. So we're going to drag and drop. Bring that up to the front. This is the file. Drag it over here. Boom, it's in there. All right. Now, this is how you add the audio track. You go to audio and select track. Now, it gives you a number of other tracks to work with, and this would suggest that you could just mix them here. I've tried that and it doesn't work. Whenever I do it, it will only play the first track that's here, no matter how many others I've listed and checked off and filtered, configured, etc., etc. So, I don't know. When I figure that out, I'll let you know. For the time being, I've been mixing it in Mixcraft, but theoretically speaking, you should be able to do this in AvidMux. Regardless, what we are going to do is replace the original track with our track that we have created in Captures. All right. Okay. And that's it. Now we have it. So once that's completed, and if the timing is off for any reason, this is really handy. You can just click the shift box. So like say the audio sync isn't on with your lips, like I'm talking right now. I always have to do this with these videos actually, at the end, is you click the shift and then you can put in a number in the form of milliseconds. So if you put like 1,000, that's actually 1 second. Okay, so I usually have to shift it by around 520 milliseconds. And it'll shift the audio forward or backwards. If you put 520, that's forward. And if you put a minus in front of it, it becomes backwards. But in this case, it's not necessary at all because there's no lips in the video to be synced to. So once that's done and you're happy with the end results, you can then save the file. Oh, I'm gonna have to do this over again. The other thing about AvidMux that I've noticed, and this is really important, if you're working with an AVI file, and that little handheld camera I showed you always records in the format of AVI, for some reason, when you record with this, or when you add tracks or edit any video, whether you mess with the audio or not, the audio cuts out about 1 to 2 minutes in. I've accidentally posted a number of videos not realizing this. So that's why it's really important to always go through your creations and make sure that everything is tip top. rushing ahead ends up lands you with uploading bad content. And the only remedy I've found for this so far is to convert the AVI file into an MP4 format first, which you want to do anyway because MP4 is a much better compression, and so it drastically cuts down your upload time. And some of these files, when they get as long as like this one is, can be huge and take for a really long time when you've only got a 1 megabit upload. So what I have to do for this is something else entirely, and I'll get back. Well, screw it. I'll show you how I do this. All right, we're gonna close up. There's a free app that Microsoft offers called Easy Movie Maker. If you go to the Microsoft Store, right here, and type in Easy Movie Maker, this will pop up. It's a free download. Use transcoding tools. We're going to change it to MP4. Alright, got to find the file once again, which was in here. Alright. Export video, P4, frame auto, file name, direction, select a directory where you want to save it. and submit. And it will proceed with converting the file from an AVI to an MP4 format. Alright. That's it. We're good. Alright, so we go back, close that. We go back to AvidMux. And we go to our captures directory and solar reflection where we save the new file. Bring this back up to the front, drag that over there. Alright. Now, right away, you can see this is a much brighter picture. And you can see it much better. That was why I noticed right away that something was wrong. Alright. Go back, audio, select track, add audio track. Spacebar works in here too, to stop and start it. And you can use your arrow keys to go forward and backwards. Left and right go slow, up and down go fast. Alright, save. Oh, and now that it's in MP4, as you see up here, the only thing you need to change as far as settings is the output format. You want to change it to MP4 Muxer. And this is really only important for one reason, because it'll work either way. But if you don't put MP4 Muxer, when you go into your folders and look at these files, it will look like this instead of this. It won't give you the little preview window, and that appears to be the only difference it makes, which is a big difference for me. So I change it to MP4 Muxer now. You can save it. Solar reflection, AV mix 1. And you don't need to put the format, it'll automatically save it as an MP4. This has been successfully saved. Let's go check it out. That's it. There you have it. A to Z, how to add and remix your own audio for any video that you create. If you have any questions or comments, please put them in the post. I am always happy to respond, and if you ask something that interests me, I will almost certainly do a video on how to do it. Have a good one.